All should listen him, listen her. When Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu was injured, the people, they asked him that nominate anyone as your successor. So Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu refused. Yes. Yes. Ali radiallahu anhu was injured. The people asked him that nominate someone as your successor. But Ali radiallahu anhu refused. Then the people said that appoint Hassan radiallahu anhu as your successor. Ali radiallahu anhu refused. And then people asked that you are going to meet Allah. So what you will reply to Allah? When Allah will ask you to whom you have made responsible for the Ummah. Ali radiallahu anhu replied that I will reply to my Allah that I have left the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for you. Who is better for them? Decide. You have to decide for them. Yani Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu was not agreed to appoint his own son as successor. Why? He don't want kingship. Then the people, after the death of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they by themselves they elected or selected Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu. What does it show? That Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was not fond of these worldly gains, that is power, that is wealth, whatever. As some people, they criticize Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So it shows Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu was never interested for this post by himself. During the time of election of Usman, he voted for Usman. When Usman radiallahu ta'ala anhu was assassinated, he was not willing to accept this office. Then the people, they convinced him. And now it was the time, there was no opposition of Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. On this side, in Syria, Hazrat Mir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, okay. But this all area was with Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And people are asking him to nominate his son, but he refused. It means ke never he was interested for this thing. He took it as responsibility. And now he didn't appoint his own son. So people accepted Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu as caliph. So 6 months of Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu reign, it is considered as rightly guided caliph's tenure or span, according to hadith. So Ali's time plus 6 months of Hazrat Imam Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they are included in rightly guided caliph span of time. Now about Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Hazrat Hassan and Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, grandsons of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu born, Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu born, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave adhan and ikama in their ears, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made the names Hassan and Hussain. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved too much both of them, and he said, "These are my flowers." And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that about these two people, that they sayyade shababe ahle jannah, mean they are the chief of the youth of jannah. And you know, in jannah there will be no old men, all people will be young. And this is not only that they were the grandsons of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that's why he gave them these ranks. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew about it, that in future how much they are going to contribute for Muslim Ummah, how much sacrifices they are going to do. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about Hazrat Imam Hussain radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that Al Husainu minni wa ana min Al Husain, that I am from Hussain and Hussain is from me. And once Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Oh Allah, I love Hussain, you love Hussain." And he said, the one who loves Hussain loves me, and who loves Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam loves Allah. Once Hazrat Hassan, Hussain and Abdullah bin Umar or some other son of Umar in their childhood, they were playing in Medina. As the children are playing, so there was little bit conflict between these children. So Hassan and Hussain, they said to Ibn Umar that you are our slave, your father is our slave. Now that child became very angry that my father is caliph, they are saying this. He went to his house, he told his father that Hassan and Hussain, they are saying this thing. Hazrat Umar radiyallahu anhu said, okay, go and ask them to write it and then come to me. Now Ibn Umar was very happy that now my Baba will punish them in writing, I'm going to take this. So he went, he asked them, what you have said, give me in writing. They wrote it. And when he came back to his father, Umar radiyallahu anhu took that piece and he said, when I will die, keep it in my grave with my body. When Allah will ask me questions, I will show him this certificate that I am the slave of Ahlul Bayt. So this was his love for this family. And Hazrat Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he requested Hazrat Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu to marry with his daughter Umme Kulsoom, daughter of Fatima and Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Why? He said, I want to become the part of your family. This was his love for this family. Now, when we see these two brothers, how did they contribute it? First about Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu. When he saw that two groups of Muslims, they had fight already in Siffin, and now again there are chances of fight due to the conflict between Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now there was again chance of fight, but due to negotiation, Hazrat Hassan and Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they agreed for peace treaty. Hazrat, yes.
Did they get the revenge for Uthman's from his murders till now? Didn't they get it?
This question was addressed by your teacher or not? You asked it or not?
No.
Actually, it is very critical question, and it will take too much time to explain it. Let me complete this, then if there will be time. Okay, come on. Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he withdrew from the caliphate office in the favor of Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. By this way, whole Islamic empire from Afghanistan to Africa became the one, and Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the ruler of this empire. Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he led his left of the life in Medina, but as there were some points of that treaty, one of them was this, that Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he will not appoint his successor. He will follow the pattern of Hazrat Abu Bakr, Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He will make Shura, and Shura will decide about the new successor after the death of Hazrat Amir Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. This point later on became the reason of conflict again between Hazrat Imam Hussain and Yazid. So let me complete about Hazrat Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Now Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhu, because from his childhood he was too much fond of ibadah during the nights, and all these states were in him. So he led his life, but he was poisoned by his wife, one of his wife. So due to that poison, he couldn't survive and he died in Medina. He was